are, for us, the three learning components of the pastoral cycle. One is the why, which means that somehow we cannot go into reality without at the back of our minds the assumption of what ought to be. And what ought to be comes from either a humanistic philosophy or a Christian philosophy. And that therefore all those who are going to try to find out the reality must be able to be informed, or they must imbibe somehow a human philosophy or a Christian philosophy. So with the why, you then have the what. The what is means what is the reality, and through that the what is being undertaken because of certain theories and analytical tools. So the why and the what and the how is the process of how you bridge the what is with what ought. Okay, this will be better explained with the next slide. Okay, the humanistic and Christian philosophy, the why. The first learning component provides one with a worldview, a way of looking at reality, a way of seeing, because it's a way of seeing that makes you think in a new way, in the way that you see. So seeing leads to, if you have a new way of seeing, you will have a new way of thinking. You will have a new way of feeling. You will have a new way of relating, and then a new way of being. That's the whole transformative process. Then a worldview, so the first learning component gives a force, a motive force for action. And it is also a source of a vision in life. We, in our Christian life, we always talk about the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God, in which one theologian translated this kingdom of God in a Filipino way of thinking, because we don't have experience of kingdom, ang pamamayari ng kagandahang loob ng Diyos. Ang pamamayari ng kagandahang loob ng Diyos. And that is, will be more understandable to people here. A motive. So it is the why that gives us a dream, that gives us a vision in life. That is the why. It gives us a vision in life. Kingdom of God. That's always what we're talking about. And I think that the visit of Francis, our beloved Pope Francis, had shown to us a vision in life. A vision that all hearts must be Christian hearts. All hearts must have the heart of Christ and must walk their talk, you know. And that's what Francis showed us. And even if you ask people, what did you learn from, they always say, when we were in Manila, it's very nice to be with the crowds. We can look at it on TV, but in the crowds, the people were saying, para makita nila si Cristo. Para kahit ngayon na lang ang nakita na nila ay yung, hindi nila nakita yung face ni Francis. Nakita lang nila yung likod ng kotse ni Francis. Sila ay natutuwa na sapagkat para daw napiyayaan sila ng Panginoon. That's the faith of our ordinary Filipino. And I think it's very easy to make that faith blossom because every Filipino has a God experience. By the language, we know they have a God experience because they say, sa awa ng Diyos, marunong ang Diyos, salamat sa Diyos, Mabuti ang Diyos. That's an ordinary way of talking. And then translate the whole, what they are saying. Oh, the second learning component provides one, what in life. So if there is a vision in life from the why, then you ask yourself, but what is the reality? What is the reality? And then we find out the reality. So what in life are the realities? The physical realities, the ecological reality, the human realities, the social realities, the metaphysical reality. How do the people, what is the philosophy of the people? This is learned through various theoretical frameworks of analysis. But we in ASI are biased for the phenomenological approach. And I'm sure you know this because you've studied philosophy, existential phenomenology. So most of our dissertations and theses are narratives. Narratives of people's lives, they reflect on it, they get certain things, they get the core of the life of the person. And that dissertation or thesis becomes very transformative for the thesis writer as well as for the panelists and all those who read their thesis. Okay, so that's the what. The third learning component is this. If there is a vision in life from the how, from the why, but there is a gap between the vision and the reality, what do you do to bridge the gap between the why and the what? And this is now the how, or the process that tries to bridge the vision, the idea rooted in a philosophy of life and or faith, source of a worldview, and the reality of experience or facts that are derived from theoretical frameworks of analysis or from experience or from a phenomenological approach. And I think it is nicer to make people tell their stories because all people have their stories to tell, especially here in the Philippines. People love to tell the stories. When I was still a child here near Sampaloc Lake, we children have a story to tell about every tree in our grandmother's backyard. It's a pity I was not a sociologist then, but it would be nice. But we used to tell the story of the legend of Sampaloc Lake and the moral lesson that you could get from it. That's why Sampaloc Lake is called the Lake of My Childhood. The Lake of My Childhood, which was so beautiful before, it was round with coconut groves. But right now, it's not that round anymore. It's not that clear anymore because of the degradation of the environment. However, it is cleaner now than when the years back I saw it. Something died within me because it was not anymore the lake noon. Hindi kami pwedeng tumuro sa lake, may mga sirena daw doon. Kaya. But this is so real to us at the time, you know. That was near the hospital, there was a tennis court there where we used to skate, you know. It was very nice. I think it was here that I made my first communion in the cathedral. So every time I go to the cathedral, that whole thing, I still remember the song that I sung. Jesus, thou art coming, holy as thou art. And told me, my sister said, you don't think of your dress, you think of Jesus in your heart. And that stayed on. And then every time there is Flores de Mayo, we used to gather all flowers, kalachuchi, maraming ganyan, and then we would throw flowers to the Virgin. So when I look at the Virgin there, and then I look at the altar, I go back again to the childhood. That was the time that I learned how to sacrifice, because that was war time. And we were just rationed with kamote. And my sisters would say, if you're going to make your first communion, you should give up your kamote. And I am a lututo. So, just gave them away. And I still remember my father, who is not even a, not educated, but I still remember that he was reading the gospel to us. That is, and that the processions, when there are processions, we would be, the children would be nasa bentalilla with our legs hanging there, and adults are standing with a candle. I still remember that. And all of these get the impression of how we grew up in the faith. Okay, third learning. The three components, therefore, the pastor's title is the why, the humanistic Christian philosophy, the what, and to bridge the gap, the how. And then, if you have the subset there, you go into a cycle of reality assessment, which is like seeing. You make an action that is reality assessment gives you hope.